Imagine, you're 78 years old. You've worked hard your whole life. You've amassed a nest egg that might last you 10 or 20 years. A second grandchild has come along, a child with whom you might like to spend some time. But if you're an average American with an average American lifestyle and an average set of genes, you're not predicted to live another year. But now imagine you're on your deathbed, and somebody could come along with a little piece of paper, and on that paper is a formula that could give you up to 8 good years of life. What would that be worth? We found the ingredients to that formula in places around the world called Blue Zones. Blue Zones are places around the world where people live the longest, healthiest lives, oftentimes to 100 years or even older. Over the past few years, myself, Dan Buettner, and a group of world-renowned experts from National Geographic, universities, and medical institutions put together the Blue Zones Expedition Team. We've journeyed to these longevity hotspots to identify threads in lifestyles, diet, outlook, and stress coping mechanisms of some of the world's oldest, healthiest people. We wanted to find out what these people were doing in order to gain these extra healthy years. Our first Blue Zone visit took us to the island of Sardinia, about 125 miles off the coast of Italy. For 4 weeks, I led an expedition up to the mountainous Nuoro province. We used a method developed by scientists at the National Institute on Aging to interview 20 centenarians, mostly men, since Sardinia has the most male centenarians than any place else in the world. We studied how these men shed stress, how they interacted, what their religion was, how medicine played into it. We wanted to shed some light on how they lived to be so old and healthy, perhaps learn from some of their lessons. The person who most exemplified the Blue Zone centenarians was a man named Tonino Tola. This is a guy who loved to walk. Each day he walked between 5 and 7 miles, mostly tending sheep, but also visiting his friends and his family. Like most Sardinians, he also loved his wine. He drank small amounts of it all day long, a little bit during the morning, at lunch, and then again when he met with his friends at day's end. Sardinian Continental wine, as it turns out, has the highest level of polyphenols in the world. Tonino also ate largely a plant-based diet, except on Sundays when he ate a little bit of meat. Most importantly, he loved his family. Everything he did was for them. And now they helped take care of Tonino. As we recently learned, people who live in strong families live 2 to 4 years longer than people who don't. Our next stop was Loma Linda, California, about 70 miles east of Los Angeles in the San Bernardino Valley. Loma Linda is more of a cultural Blue Zone than it is a geographic one. It's home to the greatest concentration of Seventh-day Adventists in the world. We know that Adventist women who most strictly follow the recommendations of their church live about 8 years longer than their American counterparts. And men live almost 11 years longer. Their diet is taken directly out of the Bible. Genesis chapter 1. They avoid meat, eat mostly plant-based foods like nuts, soy, whole grain, and wheats. They avoid alcohol and tobacco, so they're not big partiers, but it's working for them. Every week they have a 24-hour period between sundown Friday and sundown Saturday. They call it sort of a sanctuary in time. It's their Sabbath. During this time, they focus on their God, on their family, and they take long walks through nature. One of my favorite Adventists was a 93-year-old multimillionaire named Ellsworth Wareham. When Ellsworth wanted to build a fence in his backyard, the contractor quoted him $5,000. He said, well, for that price, I'll just do it myself. So he went out there with shovels, concrete, heavy poles, and for the next 2 days, labored away. On the third day, he ended up in the hospital, but not as the patient, but as the surgeon, doing open-heart surgery. And then there's my favorite, Marge Jaton, who at 101 starts her day riding her bike and pumping iron. She then gets into her 1994 Cadillac Seville, where she barrels down the San Bernardino Freeway. She volunteers for 7 different organizations, including a senior citizen daycare center where most of the residents are 30 years younger than she is. Now that's vitality. We found the world's longevity all-stars 800 miles south of Tokyo on the island of Okinawa, specifically a tiny peninsula called Motobu. This is the area that has the highest disability-free life expectancy in the world. In other words, these people enjoy the longest, healthiest lives of anybody else. Here, there are five times as many centenarians than we have in the U.S. They live an average of 7 years longer than Americans, and they suffer about a fifth the rate of the cancers that kill us and have one-sixth the rate of cardiovascular disease. These are people who have something to teach us. Why? Well, to start with, Okinawans eat a plant-based diet, including about eight times the amount of tofu that we do. Tofu hasn't gained popularity in America, but it's arguably the world's most perfect food. Several studies suggest that eating the right amount and the right kinds of tofu can reduce your chances of getting cancer and heart disease. It may even help women's skin look younger. And then, there's this thing Okinawans call hara hachibu, which is an adage that reminds them to push themselves away from the table when their stomachs are 80% full. If Americans could just stop eating when their stomachs were 80% full, we would lose an average of 17 pounds apiece every year. Next, we have this notion of ikigai. In America, we tend to divide our lives into two phases. We have the work phase and then the retirement phase. But in Okinawa, there's only one phase. They don't even have a word for retirement. Ikigai means the reason for which I wake up in the morning. And this notion imbues their entire life. It's this sense of purpose that I believe helps propel people past their 100th birthday with vigor and vitality. My favorite centenarian in Okinawa is an absolute legend. She's 104-year-old Ushi Okashima. She just got a job 2 years ago working at a roadside market where she's really a celebrity figure. She wakes up every day, prepares her own food. At noon, she lunches with her children. She may head out into her garden for a couple hours. At 5 o'clock, her friends come over, they share a little bit of sake wine, catch up on the village gossip, and then she's in bed at 9 o'clock every night. Time spent with Ushi, even if it's just a few moments, is absolutely magical. She possesses a calmness and a wisdom that is truly inspiring. From our experiences with centenarians, the Blue Zone Expedition team has assembled 8 simple secrets that we believe can help the average American get up to 8 good years of life. First, eat a plant-based diet. Emphasize nuts, beans, and some tofu. It doesn't mean you can't eat any meat at all. It just means limited portions twice a week. Number 2, get regular low-intensity exercise. The key for the long run is not doing marathons, not pumping iron. It's low-intensity things like gardening or walking with your friends. Or I think the best thing is playing with your children. Not only do you get the physical activity, but you also better the relationship with your children. Number 3, invest in family. That doesn't mean being an ATM for your children, but rather it does mean maybe knocking off of work a couple hours early to spend that time with your kids. Number 4, practice a communal faith. It doesn't matter if you're Muslim, Christian, or Jewish. The point is that once a week or so, you come together as a community. You're much less likely to engage in risky behaviors, and you have scheduled meditation every week. That reduces stress. Number 5, identify what your sense of purpose is. The Okinawans call it ikigai, the reason for which they wake up in the morning. This sense of purpose seems to propel people to their 90s, even their 100s. Number 6, hara hachibu. This simple reminder to push yourself away from the table when your stomach is 80% full will not only help you reach age 100, it'll help you do so fit and thin. Number 7, you can feel free to drink a little bit of wine at the end of every day. People who drink 1 to 2 glasses of wine a day live longer than people who don't drink at all. Number 8, build a personal longevity culture. These spry centenarians never belonged to a gym, they never signed up for any diet program, but what they all had in common is they either all were born into or consciously joined a group of people who help reinforce the right behaviors. Science has not figured out how we can turn back our body's clock, but we can all get more good years out of life and more life out of our years. The answers lie with the time-honored practices of the world's longest-lived people. These are the centenarians we met in the Blue Zones. Exploring the world's longest-lived cultures can change our lives. Their stories can move us, motivate us, teach us. All we need do is take the time to listen. Live large.